We started meeting on this project, which involved unmanned aerial vehicles and human factors. We started meeting on this project, oh, probably 10 years ago. Issues related to unmanned aerial vehicles, what's the engineering side of it, what's the nutrition side, what's the aviation side, what's the human factors and psychology side. And then as more folks started to realize, hey, this is something that's really important, and more people were, you know, seeing that, you know, we need to fund this, we need to expand upon this, then it kind of grew and grew and grew, and now there's a whole center of unmanned aerial vehicle research on campus and teaching and training.
My role was basically coming up with an idea for a ground-based risk mitigation strategy for the flight of unmanned aircraft systems in the National Airspace System. Senator Dorgan had earmarked some funds to the University of North Dakota through the United States Air Force, and the United States Air Force wanted to find out what basically we were capable of doing. And Greg Pierce, the technical advisor, came up from Creech Air Force Base, and he was blown away by the fact that you actually can work together, you know, meaning different colleges. I guess he had been to a number of different places around the country, and everybody was arguing with each other by the time they got done with their presentations. But he liked what we could do, he liked what we had planned on doing, and we wound up getting the work from the Air Force. We have such an incredible group of people on this campus that when we get together, great things happen. And this was just an example of it.
I've had projects where I've been able to work with every area of campus, and they've all been wonderful to work with. The medical school, the engineering department, the law school, everybody, business school, they've all had somebody that at some point or other has been helpful in working with us. And that's really what's made our research happen. It isn't so much what we do, but what everybody does together.
The engineering school as a whole has been kind of a go-to for development of new technology. So I think the growth and maturity of the industry, I think, you know, in particular, some of our work on sense-and-avoid systems, UND actually owns a patent based upon those technologies that were developed. That's a real, you know, individual thing that can be recognized easily, but there's just so much work in a broad spectrum. And I think, you know, work that other faculty members and staff and students in this area was initiated by the members of this group that's being recognized. And it has grown and it's sustained for such a long time. That's something to really be proud of, I think.
There was a seventh person involved, Dick Schultz. He was very integral in the engineering aspect, but unfortunately he died of cancer a few years ago.
He was the chair of the engineering, electrical engineering department, a wonderful fellow. In fact, the award is dedicated to him.